In this video, I'd like to tell you about COMPAS, which stands for Correctional Offender Management Profiling for Alternative Sanctions. It is a risk scoring algorithm used to assess a criminal defendant's likelihood of becoming a recidivist. It was developed by North Point Incorporated and is used in several U.S. states to support the decisions of judges and parole boards during criminal sentencing. Now, as mentioned, the software was meant to help law enforcement and court systems to predict the risk of recidivism as well as the risk for violent recidivism. An offender's COMPAS score was used to determine whether or not to release or detain a defendant before his or her trial. In order for COMPAS to generate a risk score, defendants completed a survey, which collected up to 137 data points. Based on algorithmic and machine learning processes, which were not fully disclosed by the developers, COMPAS produced a score ranging from 1, a low risk, to 10, a high risk. In 2016, a ProPublica report drew attention to what turned out to be racist bias evident in the algorithm used. More specifically, the analysis found that 1, Black defenders were more often predicted to be at a higher risk of recidivism than they actually were. Indeed, ProPublica's analysis found that Black defendants who did not recidivate over a two-year period were nearly twice as likely to be misclassified as higher risk compared to their white counterparts. In turn, 2, white defendants were often predicted to be less risky than they actually were. The analysis found that white defendants who reoffended within the next 2 years were mistakenly labeled as low risk almost twice as likely and twice as often as their Black reoffenders. The analysis further showed that even when controlling for prior crime, future recidivism, age, and gender, Black defendants were 45% more likely to be assigned a higher risk score than their white defendants. So 3, Black defendants were also twice as likely as white defendants to be misclassified with being a higher risk of violent recidivism. And white violent recidivists were 63% more likely to have been misclassified as a low risk of violent recidivism compared to Black violent recidivists. The violent recidivism analysis also showed that when controlling for prior crimes, future recidivism, age, and gender, Black defendants were 77% more likely to be assigned a higher risk score than their white co-defendants. Post-analysis revealed that race was considered to be a predictor for higher risk of recidivism. Moreover, addressing explainability and accuracy issues, in 2018, a study showed that the same prediction accuracy that was obtained by processing 137 data points could be obtained through the analysis of just 7 features. How the 137 features were processed and how their interplay led to a certain algorithm outcome remains mostly unexplainable. The misclassifications resulted in longer pretrial prison stays for some Black defendants that were in actuality unlikely to recidivate, as well as the release of some white defendants that were in fact more likely to recidivate. Despite the public outcry, as well as the racism and fairness concerns, COMPAS is still used in some U.S. states.